Hey everyone, today is an incredibly special treat here at MX Data because not only is the one and only Megan Grove joining us as usual, today we have a brand new, right off the shelf, get it? It's a retail joke. Jada Bates, everybody, welcome Jada Bates. So Megan, why don't you start us off, introduce yourself and introduce Jada.
Okay. Hi, everybody. I'm Megan Grove. I'm the customer engineer at MX Data. Thank you so much for watching. As usual, we always have great and exciting content that we like to talk about just to educate our retailers about all the products and services that MX Data offers, but also technology solutions that are available to you to drive sales and increase brand awareness as far as, and also plan implementation strategic growth. So I'm happy to introduce Jada Bates, who's new to MX Data, kind of. She's been around for a few months, but she is a new sales and marketing associate that we have here, and she has really helped MX Data, along with some retailers, really increase their social media presence, and we're kind of happy and excited to talk about social media and how it affects the retail industry in today's world.
Yes, thank you, Megan. Yes, my background is in social media marketing, so I have been with MX Data a few months and have loved the journey in the retail industry, and I'm excited to talk about social media today.
Fantastic. So as promised, we're starting off with a joke. Usually we'll flip it around, but this coming weekend is Labor Day weekend. So of course, most people are going to be on vacation. Megan, where is MX Data going to be this weekend?
MX Data will be in Dallas, Texas, attending the Retail Pro Global Conference.
So will that be a vacation? Will you be working? A little balanced?
A little bit of both. Yes, we'll be working, but Retail Pro has super fun, exciting activities for us to do in the evenings. It'll be a good networking and kind of like a vacay, especially for my children. So I'll take it. All right. Although I don't know what to pack because it's like 105 degrees in Dallas, but I feel like we're going to be indoors the whole time. And all I keep talking to Jada about is what do I pack to go to Dallas? It's driving me nuts. So
that's an important retail question. So
Right. Let's
jump into it, shall we? So we have been on social media since the beginning of social media, but there are definitely new trends that have been happening even in 2023. Obviously, social media 10 years ago is different from what it was pre-COVID, pre-2020. And today, there are different ways for companies, retailers, and non-retailers to take advantage of those trends. So I'd love for you guys to tell our audience some of the trends that are going on right now and how retailers and others, if they're listening, can take advantage of these trends.
Yeah, I'll start. I think definitely I've noticed in the past couple of years, really since COVID, a lot of the short form videos, like we know on social media, Instagram would be Reels. TikTok is a really big thing, I feel like, in the younger generation. Things like this really grabs users' attention. And we've even implementing, you know, with our digital fireside chats, everyone wants something that catches them right off the bat. And they're like, what is that? For retailers, I think, you know, I've seen them joining TikTok and doing the short videos on Instagram and things like that. Target, they do a lot of, you know, there's influencers who will put together an outfit and I'm like, oh, that's really cute. I want to go buy that. So, you know, catching people's attention like that, I think, has really grown in the past couple of years.
Megan, are you following any particular influencers within the retail industry? Has anything caught your eye lately?
Well, a lot has caught my eye. I would say the biggest one that I follow is one of our customers, Hypebeast. They do a really great job on social media. Their presence is huge. I think they have like something over 10 million followers. And they do a really good job of marketing, not just like their products and merchandise, but the brand altogether. So I think they're a good example. There's others, Izumiaki, Pair Jumpers, Click Galleries, a couple other ones that we follow. And I think all of them do a really good job of displaying, like I said, not only the merchandise, but the brand altogether.
So let's talk a little bit about short form video specifically. You had mentioned that before, Jada. The trend in the industry used to be text. So you put up a text in Twitter or in Facebook or LinkedIn, and then people started putting up pictures. But when the internet started getting a lot faster, shall we say, people were able to upload videos. I've definitely seen this trend of more and more companies putting up videos. But Jada, maybe you could tell us what's the process of creating a video, curating that video, editing that video, and then finally uploading it? What's your process?
Yeah, I definitely think that with the progression of the short form videos, there's a lot more work that does go in from the back end with the marketing side of things. I think it's worth it, but you know, you have to take the time to gather the content, combine the content, make sure that it has, you know, if it's going to be a reel, you want the good music that's trending right now in the background so that that gets more people viewing it, things like that. You want to make sure it's edited correctly. So I do think that there's more that goes into it than just the older way of doing it, which was just the pictures and the text. But I think it's great. It's more entertaining. You know, people are spending more time on social media in general for business, shopping, everything. So yeah.
And the length too, Jada, the length of the video. So one thing that you've noticed, because you've brought up, is you have to get your message in fast. Like if you're posting a video that's longer than like 20 or 30 seconds, you've lost your audience. It's got to be make the punch point quick right off the bat. And it really then ends up drawing in the consumer.
You bring up a really good point. In comedy, don't tell anyone. And especially if this video goes viral, I did a little stand-up comedy a number of years ago. If you don't get to the joke, if you don't get to the point quick enough, you lose your audience. It's not like people are going to wait around for the punchline. No. And really, that's what influencer marketing and short form video is, that if you're using an influencer, there is an immediate connection with the audience. And in that short form video, it's got to be, it's a 1-2 punch. It's not a, let me roll on and on and on. But to that effect, Megan, did you see when T-Mobile came out with their commercial and social media platform and campaign? They had Ozzy Osbourne with Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
That went viral incredibly fast because here was an icon of the music industry put together with, as you were saying, Jada, something that's new, someone that's new and that can engage with the audience. So they were really connecting both sides. So my question is, Megan, first to you, is how does a retailer afford all these big pop stars and like how much money is going into influencer marketing?
Well, a lot, because if you think about it, the days of like the billboards, which used to cost a fortune, or marketing in magazines or radio advertising or even commercials, you know, you don't really see a whole lot of commercials even on the TV these days if you're watching, especially like the smart TVs where a lot of them don't even have the commercials. So retailers have kind of taken that budget and refocused and re-strategized about how to now reach the consumer. One thing that we've even seen too is, you know, a lot of emails. And I think there was a period in time where retailers would be connecting with their customer through the information that they've gathered through their point of sale solution or some alternative, and using like mail messaging or even mailers in the mail. You don't really get those anymore either. Now they're connecting on social media, where, yeah, it can be costly, but there's a lot of tools and resources, and Jada could probably speak more to that, to create the content. In fact, the tools that are offered are amazing, actually, and they're not as costly as you would think.
So, Jada, what are some of the tools that you're using? And I'm really curious because, you know, you just started here at MX Data. Who are some of the influencers that you've noticed?
Yeah, so I think for us in marketing, some tools that we use, we really like to use Agora Pulse. That helps us schedule all of our content through videos, just our normal posts, things like that. You know, we have our email marketing as well. And as far as influencers go, I was just thinking when you said Justin Bieber, this week, actually, Hailey Bieber, she has a skincare line and she partnered with Krispy Kreme. Just kind of funny. You're probably like, why makeup and skincare with donuts? But she started this trend this year to get the glazed look. You know, everyone wants the glowing skin. And she came out with a strawberry lip balm. And so it's strawberry glazed. And so they did a strawberry glazed donut. So I thought that was really cool. That actually happened this week as far as influencer marketing. So I think she's definitely someone, you know, going back to Hypebeast, I really think that they use a lot of big name famous people through their marketing that I think they really show that as that, you know, to be a great point as well.
So actually, another point on that too is, Rafi, to answer your question lastly, is it's a win-win for both, right? So even like with Hailey Bieber and Krispy Kreme, they're cross-marketing. So it's not like one is getting, you know, more attention or more views or consumer engagement than the other. It's kind of like cross-marketing. It's a win-win for both.
You know, so getting back into the short form video, I noticed on Amazon specifically, as we all know, one of the largest, if not the largest, sorry, largest retailer online. Anytime I look at a product, they have a short video that usually accompanies the product. I'm curious if you both have experience with not only seeing that video on the page itself in the Amazon product, but also outside in their social media.
Happens to me all the time. I'll go to a website, I see something, and then next thing I know, it's on my scroll of social media.
Yes, absolutely. And speaking on Amazon too, we've recently bought a home. And so I'm trying to, you know, buy all the things to furnish the house. And Amazon is just your go-to for everything. And I found that Amazon has their own Instagram for Amazon Home. And, you know, they push advertising on social media. So I'll be scrolling on Facebook or Instagram. And here it is, Amazon Home in this beautiful room. And I'm like, I want all of these things. And they link it so I can go there immediately. And it's a great marketing tactic for sure.
Well, actually, so back to it comes up on social media then if you're like on a website. So actually 76% of retailers have said that their business have grown, I think like by maybe 82%. Of social media, like e-commerce, like online buying, because you can link where to buy it right there within your social media post. It usually will either direct somebody right back to their website to buy instantly, or some people even have online stores like through Facebook, if you're using Facebook, for example, where you can just buy the item right there on Facebook. So that has been huge as well.
Well, that was the vision, I remember in the industry, when the industry was just starting up over 20 years ago, that, you know, oh, you see Michael Jackson is a bad example because he's no longer living. But to me, the best Super Bowl halftime performance in the last decade was Lady Gaga. She was just incredible. Her energy, her music, she really connected with the audience. And I think I might be mixing up what she was wearing on for a dress versus her shoes, because she did so many costume changes. But we always used to say, okay, you saw it on Super Bowl halftime show. Lady Gaga's wearing it. Click here to purchase. Have you seen this like in real life happening?
You can click on everything these days to purchase. I mean, on your phone, on your computer, in an app, on a website, in store. Yeah, there's a lot of resources and opportunities to click here to buy, yes. But that's what's hard for retailers to know, is how to navigate that and what are all the options available. So, you know, that can be tricky, and that's kind of why we're talking about this too.
Well, one of the things, Megan, you and I have discussed a lot over the past few months is clicking to purchase online, but then picking up at the store. So I'd love to hear more about that, you know, how retailers can do that and how MX Data works with them.
Yes. So that can be tricky. It does take a lot of planning, and it requires a very good inventory control management system, which we like to promote with Retail Pro. Because unless you're keeping all of your inventory levels accurate and in real time, you know, that you can cause major problems with that kind of thing. But yeah, MX Data, we have ShipMX, which is our web order management and fulfillment solution. It integrates Retail Pro with an e-commerce platform. Our most popular, we've talked about Shopify, Magento, even WooCommerce. And ShipMX allows retailers to offer that buy online pickup in store. And there's all different kinds of rules, allocation rules that you can put into place just to make sure that retailers are fulfilling in the smartest, most cost efficient way possible. So yeah, we help with that.
I was, you know, I was hoping that you'd be able to get a little more into the weeds, how MX Data connects with our retail partners. Talk about tagging, hashtagging, you know, explain that to the audience and how does all that work?
Yeah, so we love our connections with our retailer partners and we really like to promote our partnerships on our social media. And, you know, we do that through our webinars that we host and then just promoting them in normal social media posts and tagging them, hashtagging. We use LinkedIn a lot to make sure that we're connecting and doing all of that properly. And I think that's a really big part of who MX Data is and how we carry ourselves and have the relationships with our partners, because that is really important to us.
Megan, does this come up in the whole idea of social media, does it come up in meetings with your retail partners?
It does, not as much as we would hope. And that's kind of why, you know, we wanted to bring it up because it is such a huge part of the retail industry. What comes up is retailers struggle with where to start. And then we kind of have those initial conversations, like, let us just help you get off the ground. And it definitely it's something they have to do internally. But we can kind of help navigate, you know, the best starting points and give tips on what works and what doesn't work and the most successful paths to choose from.
We, you know, it just reminds me when we were talking with Libby Shani, and she was talking about how the Instagrammable...
She needs to trademark that. Instagrammable moment.
Right, the Instagrammable moment. So I brought up, when you're in Times Square and there's the huge M&M, at the M&M store, and everyone from around the country and around the world gets a picture with the big M&M, like that's an Instagrammable moment. Yeah. How do you consult with these companies on who, what, when, where, why? Like obviously M&M, they put a big M&M, but if you're, you know, Joe Retailer, how do you even brainstorm and come up with stuff like that?
Well, really, we would suggest and recommend, you know, you do need to hire someone that is in marketing because marketing has changed so much. And so, you know, a retailer can be creative, you know, a fashion designer can be creative, a business owner can be creative. But when it comes to really understanding what works in marketing today, and especially through social media, we would really recommend that you kind of take that in-house and hire someone who has the education and the knowledge and the experience in what really works today, because it almost is like a trickle effect. We've talked about this in our meetings. It's like all of a sudden you'll start talking about something and then you get an idea and then that leads to another idea. And it's good to have somebody who really knows what they're doing to help with that.
Data, have you seen this in the work that you've done, the Instagrammable moment?
Yeah, I definitely think even just day to day going in stores, you see, how people try and create the Instagrammable moments. And a lot of people do it well. And then some you're like, I don't know, it was that supposed to be the Instagrammable moment? But I love that Libby kind of created that slogan. And it is so true in today's retail world.
And that would be an example of where we would sort of lead a retailer to start with assistance, because Libby does do like the employee sort of I don't want to call it training, but kind of, but like management when even new stores kind of open, and try to help employees learn how to create the brand awareness and how to bring value to be able to create those Instagrammable moments. So that'd be an example of, you know, where we would sort of lead a retailer to go.
You know, I'm also curious just in terms of pivoting and marketing strategies. Have you recognized or noticed any, maybe in 2023 and going into 2024, have you noticed any of your retail partners that have been able to pivot, you know, in that brainstorm session where they're like, oh, that's a great idea? Can you think of any examples?
I'd say Click is a good example. One of our retailers, Click Gallery, they have 11 locations around the United States, and they do very well in store, but e-commerce and social media was one thing that they were trying to grow. And it kind of started with Retail Pro, right? Let's change out your inventory control management solution so you have the tools in place to be able to bring that on. And they're really growing. They're really growing on e-commerce and also in their social media presence. So it's been good to see.
I will say, when I started, I remember mentioning to Megan, I was like, "Ooh, I love Click's Instagram. Like, it's beautiful. You know, it makes you want to go in their store and shop." So I would agree that they have done that well, because I hadn't heard of them prior to starting at MX Data, just because I am from, you know, we're remote. Everything seems to be remote these days. So I'm so far south. But yeah, I definitely follow them now and love their social media presence.
I was at a restaurant last night in New York City, a brand new vegan restaurant, never heard of it before. Amazing reviews. The presentation, first of all, of the location, number one, that hit me like I don't know if it was in an old bank or an old lobby with chandeliers. Like, it was taking the ideas that other people had, but then working it into present modern day visuals. And I'm curious, if you were mentioning before, Megan, how a company should definitely be hiring interior designers and marketers to really think not only about today, but what's going to be happening in 2 years, 5 years, maybe not 10 years, but what's the process with all of that?
Business planning. It all starts with forecasting and cash flow. And that's actually really interesting that you bring that up, because we just had a webinar this morning with Dan Jablins at Retail Smart Guys, and that's exactly what he does. He specializes in helping retailers be able to forecast, you know, not just for 1 year in advance, but 3 and 5 year plans. Because, you know, you really can't, you can't grow, you can't expand, you can't budget for anything unless you have a forecast and you have proper cash flow in place. So I would start with him. We watch our webinar and he'll be doing a digital fireside chat with us too in the next couple of weeks. So we'll talk about that.
Okay. All right. We're coming to the end. So let us know, you know, what's new at MX Data. What, you know, it's Labor Day weekend, even though you're working, most people aren't going to be working, but then it is back to school. It's back to work. September, 2023, gearing up towards fourth quarter. What's going on at MX Data and what do we have to look forward to?
Holiday planning. This is the time. You know, everybody always thinks that we all wait till fourth quarter to start talking about fourth quarter. We've been talking about holidays since July. Summer season is gone in retail. So that's kind of what we're working on. We are working on, you know, making sure people have the proper solutions in place for line busting and, you know, being able to engage customers, and the e-commerce stuff, the buy online pickup in store is huge right now for fourth quarter. So we're kind of in planning mode with a lot of our customers right now. And then, like you said, we'll be at the Retail Pro Global Conference this weekend and learning a lot about what Retail Pro has to offer in the next coming months and years. So that's exciting. And hopefully we'll have good information to relay once we get back.
Great. Data, final thoughts, or if there's one tip that you could give to retailers that are watching this right now on what they can do on social media, what would it be?
Well, I really think for right now, it is the short videos. Start implementing those more, and consistency is key. You do see, at first it might not, you might not think, oh, the short video didn't do well, but I really think being consistent, knowing who your consumer, who you want your consumer to be, and really targeting that. And if you have the funds, you know, influencer marketing, you know, find an influencer that you would like to represent your brand or partner with and go in that direction.
Thank you. Megan, final thoughts about social media?
Yeah, I mean, reach out to us because we're happy to have a conversation. We'd love to have those initial conversations. Like we said, there's always ideas and recommendations that we can put in place and lead people in the right direction to get the results that they're looking for. So we would really encourage you to please reach out to us and we'll be willing to help.
Fantastic. My final thought on this is, you know, you're going to a trade show this weekend. Everyone has a smartphone with a camera and a video camera on your smartphone. Take as much content as possible. Take as many pictures as possible. Take as much video as possible. Record conversations. Tell them that you're recording the conversations. Get videos with your partners, with your colleagues, with the speaker. If there's going to be a main speaker, a keynote speaker there, try to get pictures and video with them. And that really can help retailers in their social media. And you'll have content for the next month, for the next quarter, and the next year, depending upon how you slice it up.
And Rafi, that is exactly why you're MX Data's marketing consultant. So thank you.
Fantastic. So thank you very much once again. I am Rafi Salem, coming to you from the MX Data studios here on the internet. And check us out at mxdata.com. And we'll see you next time we're on a digital fireside chat.
Hi, thank you.
Thanks, Rafi.